Hi friends, it's Jamie and I'm here with Lindsay, and we are inside the Fallow Deer exhibit here at Indian Creek Zoo. Hi Lindsay, how's it going?
Pretty good.
Good. So we're going to talk a little bit more today about fallow deer.
Yes.
Because that's not something that's native to our area. So when zoo visitors come out and they see the fallow deer, they're very curious about them because they look a little bit different than the white-tailed deer do. Do you want to tell us a little bit about their features on their body and how, even after they are not a fawn anymore, how they will maintain some of what's on their body when they're little?
Yes, so the white-tailed deer that you see over there, you can see that a lot of them, when they are babies, the little fawns, they have those bright white spots. But you don't see that on any of the adults. So as they grow older, they outgrow that. Our fallow deer, on the other hand, they actually keep those white spots. So they'll have it when they're babies and they'll keep it as they're adults.
Nice. So fallow deer, like I said, they're not native to our area here, where if you're out on the road a lot, you're going to see those white-tailed deer. But fallow deer are native to where?
So these guys are native to Europe and parts of Asia.
Nice. Okay. So something I'm noticing here, and zoo visitors may notice as well, is their characteristics are a little bit different than the white-tailed deer as well. And I can see that as we're in their enclosure, how different they are. Can you talk to us a little bit about that?
Yes. So our white-tailed deer, you'll see they're very tall and majestic looking. These guys, on the other hand, they're more of on the shorter side. They're stocky, so they've got those shorter legs. But even though they have those short legs, they still have a lot of strength in those legs. They're still able to run extremely fast. So even though they're shorter, they still have a lot of power to them.
They do. Now their antlers are also a little bit different than the white-tailed deer. They have very flattened, the bucks have a lot, very flattened antlers.
Yes.
And I'm noticing one in here today. Can you tell us a little bit about the process on what happens with antlers on both fallow deer and white-tailed deer and even reindeer?
So these guys actually shed their antlers. So they have velvet on them and that actually comes off. So they see one of our guys in particular here, he is losing a lot of that velvet right now. So you'll see a little bit of red on his antlers. It's not necessarily hurtful to them, they're just a little bit more sensitive. And then as time passes, then it'll start getting back to that hardened antler that we all know to see.
True. So they're behind us in a distance. Why is that?
So these guys are very skittish of people, of different things. So out in the wild, they really kind of stick to themselves. They don't really try to hang out with other animals or even more of their species.
So they live more of a shy, withdrawn life in the forest because they're in the forest and the grassy areas in Europe and whatnot. So they're kind of out on their own.
Yes.
And that's what you're going to see here as well. Although our zoo visitors can feed them carrots, we have chutes set up and they do love to see our zoo guests and like to be fed carrots. And I know we have some other treats for them as well. What are some other things that they like to eat?
So they also really like their grain. Actually, that's really something they enjoy eating, but we also feed them squash and cucumber.
Nice, okay. So what else would you like us to know about the fallow deer? I know their coats can be different colors. Can you tell us a little bit about the different colors they can be?
So they can be brown, red, white, and black.
Nice. And these, I mean, I definitely see a variety inside here. And even though their white spots may not be prominent on all of those coat colors, they are there, which like you said, is a unique feature compared to the white-tailed deer that lose theirs after they are no longer a fawn.
Right.
Interesting. So I hope you've learned some facts today about our beautiful fallow deer that we have here at Indian Creek Zoo. Lindsay, thank you so much for helping us out today and helping the folks at home learn a little bit more about them.
No problem.